Good morning. Just before I begin my prepared notes, in light of why we're here today discussing public heroes, it's with deep regret that I announce one of our own public heroes, Scotty Morgan, a primary care paramedic who passed away yesterday morning. Scotty, 3 years ago, was finishing an evening shift and was en route home along the 115 highway, where he was involved in a single vehicle accident. He was ejected from the vehicle and sustained catastrophic injuries, leaving him in a wheelchair. Scotty passed away early this morning in hospital, and I just wanted to acknowledge not only his passing, but also his commitment and his dedication to the region. On behalf of Chief Cheeseborough and the 320 paramedics of the Region of Durham Paramedic Service, and also on behalf of my colleagues from surrounding paramedic services that are here today, Deputy Chief Ian Park from York Region Paramedic Service, and from Orange, I believe Steve McNenley is here in the crowd somewhere, and RDPS's very good friend, Chief Peter Dundas of Peel Region Paramedic Service. It is my great honour to welcome you to the Region of Durham and to the Intercultural Dialogue Institute's Youth Recognition Awards and media launch of the Public Heroes Award. Established in 2010, the Intercultural Dialogue Institute is a nonprofit organization whose goal is to advance social cohesion through personal interaction and promoting respect and mutual understanding among people of all cultures and faiths through dialogue and partnerships. The Public Hero Award has set in place to recognize dedication and excellence of individual members of the emergency services branches in delivering their services in an ethnically and culturally diverse environment. Recipients of these awards are chosen for their altruism, their dedication, and their multiculturalism. We have all seen the disheartening and even disturbing stories and news lately, highlighting incidences of social discord and community disharmony. This means that it is now perhaps more important than ever to remind ourselves that we are simply better together. The communities are better, stronger, and more resilient to adversity when we are attentive to and engaged with one another. Social engagement breeds compassion, tolerance, respect, and cohesion. Regardless of what sector we are in, what we decide to do for a living, or where we choose to live, we all need to remember this. Not only do we need to remember, but we also need to recognize and honor those within our community who have made it their business to enhance and support society through their work in emergency services. Recognition, though not sought after, is welcomed and much appreciated. So we thank the IDI not only for the Public Heroes Award initiative, but also for the very good and very relevant work that you good folks do. This year is particularly special as we've been given the opportunity to recognize a future community builder, a young person who exemplifies the characteristics I described before, who is yet to put their full mark on the world, or indeed perhaps yet even to recognize their full potential. The Region of Durham Paramedic Services Youth Recognition Committee nominee is Katie Tellup. Katie first came to the Region of Durham MedVents as an eager 16-year-old teenager in 2012. She thought that the medical venture program would be something interesting. Little did she know that it would lead her to her career in paramedicine. And from the beginning, Katie jumped in with both feet. Whether it was training or volunteering to perform public first aid, she was ready. Katie worked her way through the training material, earning her first aid ticket, her wilderness first aid, and finally her emergency first response. Katie was so enthusiastic about volunteering her time and working for the public that in 2013 she was recognized for the most volunteer public duty hours. Not only has Katie been an eager and enthusiastic participant in the MedVent program, she has also become a leader and a mentor to others in the program that are keen to learn. Katie has volunteered her time as vice president for 2 terms and is currently the group commissioner of the Durham Region MedVents. In 2015, Katie decided to step it up a bit. She enrolled and was accepted into the Trillium College paramedic program, from which she is now a graduate. And I understand from Katie that just 2 weeks ago, she received the results of her provincial certification exam. Success. Congratulations, Katie. We may have a place for you here in Durham. Talk to me in the spring. Katie exemplifies the type of young person we need in today's emergency services. I know she will set the example that the other young people will follow, and she will go on to become one of tomorrow's heroes. And I'm not sure if I'm supposed to invite Katie to come up now or...
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Katie Talup.